can see here, we are removing rectus femoris. So here the profunda femoris leaves the femoral triangle deep to this adductor longus muscle. Continue downwards. First it lies between the adductor longus and adductor brevis. Then it terminal part pierces the adductor magnus to anastomose with the branches of popliteal artery that you can see here. Here you can see. So here is the complete course of this profunda femoris artery. It is given by the lateral side of the femoral artery below 4 cm below the inguinal ligament. It gives off medial and lateral circumflex femoral arteries and 3 perforating arteries there. You can see here it gives the medial circumflex femoral artery. It leaves the femoral triangle passing posteriorly between pectineus and psoas major muscles. You can see pectineus muscle and iliopsoas, between them it will go there. It gives ascending and descending transverse branches. It supplies the head of the femur, and then you can see here that is the lateral circumflex femoral artery. It passes between the femoral nerve, divisions of the femoral nerve, and passes between the sartorius and rectus femoris. It divides into ascending branch, transverse branch, and you can see here the descending branch, ascending, transverse, and descending branches. You can see there ascending branch runs and supplies hip joint. The transverse branch supplies the back of thigh, whereas the descending branch descends and supplies the front of thigh. And you can see the perforating arteries here. It gives almost 4 perforating arteries. You can see here, that is these are the perforating arteries of the profunda femoris, which pass through the osteoaponeurotic openings of the adductor magnus muscle around the femur and supply all the compartment, especially back of thigh. So this femoral profunda femoris artery supplies all the compartments. It's a branch of this femoral artery.